the egg and I. It's a very simple demonstration, but it has significance to our lesson. So I want to welcome you to our little science demonstration this Sabbath morning entitled The Egg and I. And I'm going to move over. I think I have all the wires connected right. Move on over to our little table where we have a couple of glasses of water. We have two raw eggs. Now remember, when the Israelites left Egypt, their faith in God was really kind of superficial. But God saw them through all of their difficulties with no water, no food, the Egyptians on their tail at the Red Sea. And if you take a regular raw egg, and Ashley, you'll need to come around. I want you to see all this because it's important. And you put it in water, will it float or will it sink, Ashley? What do you think?
I think it will float.
Ashley thinks it will float. If it were a hummingbird egg, it might. But a hen's egg, if you put it in water, it will sink. And the reason is because it's heavier or more dense than the water. So there's our egg in this particular glass of water, sunken. And it's just like the Israelites. With all their troubles, they sunk under their problems. But God was able to raise them up and help them through it. And here is another glass of water. And I'll move this one over. And you can see it's kind of cloudy. And I'm going to tell you that I've done something to this water. But let's put this egg in the water. And it has salt added to it. So that means the water is going to be more dense than regular water. So Ashley says this particular egg in the salt water is going to float. And yes, it does. Now, it looks cloudy because you need to add one or two tablespoons of salt to it. And I wanted to make sure our egg floated, so I put 2 tablespoons and stirred it up. But it is a little more than is needed. But there it is. And those are the Israelites, supported by God. We're going to read about eagle's wings later on. And here these Israelites are with problems all around them. But if they trust God, He will raise them above their problems. Now, however, sometimes they would grumble and complain and not trust God. They would forget about God, and I don't know if we'll get it into our get into this part of our lesson this morning about the golden calf when Moses didn't come down in an appropriate time. So they thought so. They would have to return to their idols, and those are some more problems. And I want to show you what happens when more problems come on us and we don't trust God for them. Now I'm just going to, I have some plain water here. I'm just going to carefully pour in over this egg. I'm using a spoon so as not to disturb the salt water underneath. Just want a layer of water. Problems coming on to the Israelites, unforeseen. And what did they do? Did they turn to God to help them rise above the problems? No, they look to their old ways of doing things, which means going back to their idols. And here we have the Israelites. Instead of raising above their problems, they are sunk under them because they didn't trust God. Now, this is a simple little experiment done in lots of science fairs in elementary school. And what is happening here is, of course, the bottom layer is salt water. It's more dense. It causes the egg to float. But the top layer has no salt in it. And it doesn't, it allows the egg to remain sunken in the water, right? Now, just so you understand that fresh water and salt water do not mix. I'm going to put a few drops of food coloring in our fresh water and see if it will sink. The color will go down in. Now, I have to tell you, I haven't done this ahead of time, but it should work. So let's give it a try. A drop of green in the water and see what happens. It's supposed to dilute so that if you give it enough time, it will spread out in the fresh water, but the color will not sink into the salt water because fresh water and salt water do not mix. Now, that's our little demonstration about God helping us rise above our problems if we trust Him. But if we don't and we look to ourselves and our old ways of doing things before we are Christians, we're going to sink beneath our problems. Now, I'd want to share one other little thing with you because it involves nature and birds, and I'm very partial to birds. And this is for the young people in our listening audience. You can make a little bird feeder out of an orange. And that's what I did here. I cut an orange in half. You scoop out the inside of the orange with this grapefruit knife. You just zinc around it and it comes on out. And then you tie, you make two pieces of twine, 24 inches each. And then you take the point of your grapefruit thing and you bore out a hole and you tie your twine into it, opposite of each other, and then you fill this little beautiful homemade bird feeder with bird seed, just like this. And then you take it outside if you're in the country and you find a little tree to put it in. If you're in the city and you have a balcony, you can hang it somewhere. If you're in the suburbs and in the backyard, you might have a plant hook, and you can hang it out there, and the birds will come and eat from it. And we're going to put this outside in our red bush tree, where the birds often have come, except the feeder is often empty, and we're going to hang this out there. Won't that be nice? And it's very simple to do, and especially young people, 5, 6, 7 years old, they will enjoy doing this. And I have cracked corn and sunflower seeds and other seeds, millet and other seeds in there for the birds. All right, now our little science demonstration is over. I hope you understand. And we want you to return next Sabbath for the next science demonstration. And here, Ashley wants me to hold this up to show you the color stays in. You can see right there where the green line is. That's salt water, and this is fresh water above it. And the two different types of water do not mix.
What if you stirred it up?
If you stirred it up, we're going to find out, but not during Sabbath school because we... I say that because she likes to get into these demonstrations as we move on into our lesson. But I'll leave the glass there, and after Sabbath school, you may do whatever you want with it. And until we meet again, may God richly bless you.